what you learn from the society. But that has nothing to do with the reality. That's only practical. That's your life, how you live in the society. But reality, you have to rise above this duality, rise above this feeling of hatred, jealousy, competition, to understand a bigger picture. For that, a different way of thinking is required. Different way of thinking. The different way of thinking is freedom from duality. Okay? So that's all Vedanta teaches. A different way of thinking. And this thinking will make you make your mind more and more silent. Okay? A thinking which will make you more and more silent is called Vedanta. That's all. That's called Vedanta. Mind becomes silent. And mind recognizes true nature, the self. So that's a different way of thinking. Now you have attended so many classes, that's a test for you. Okay? So there is a duality. I am there and the world is there. Right? I am there, the world is there. Is there a duality in this? How many people rise? Please rise. How many people say that I am there, world is there, there's a duality? Can you please raise your hand? That's all. Everybody else says it's non-dual. Huh? Everybody else is very convinced that there's non-duality. Okay, now can you please teach her how non-duality is there in the world? Can you tell? I am there, world is there. So there is a duality. What's what you're saying? Where there is a duality, there is a stress. Okay, where there's a duality, there's a stress. Okay, this class is only to tell you there is no duality anywhere. Okay? So, yeah. You understood, no? You can tell her how there is no duality.
The duality is there in the at the transactional level. But one has to...
There's no duality at transaction level also.
For Vyavahara, we consider I'm there, the world is there, and we do that.
Even there is no duality. Okay. So anybody else who has understood non-duality there? Katya, any?
Adik, explanation no ijagrati, sopna, sushupti, adanella explanation no dada. Pratyondu no badlavane aagta ide. Adre vandu matra constant agide. ಎಲ್ಲ ಬದಲಾವಣೆಗಳನ್ನು ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇರುವಂತದ್ದು. ಸೊ ಬದಲಾವಣೆಗಳು ಪರ್ಮನೆಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಅದು ರಿಯಾಲಿಟಿ ಅಲ್ಲ.
ನೀವು ರಿಯಾಲಿಟಿ ಮಿಥ್ಯದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಿದ್ದೀರಾ, ನಾನು ಡ್ಯುಯಾಲಿಟಿ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಿದ್ದೇನೆ. ನೀವು ಟಾಪಿಕ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬಿಡಿ.
ರಿಯಾಲಿಟಿ ಯಾವಾಗ ಬರುತ್ತೆ? ಮಿಥ್ಯಾನ ನಾನು ಸತ್ಯ ಅಂತ ಅಂದ್ಕೊಂಡಾಗ ರಿಯಾಲಿಟಿ.
ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ಮಿಥ್ಯ ಸತ್ಯ, ಈವನ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ಮಿಥ್ಯ ಸತ್ಯ, ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಡ್ಯುಯಾಲಿಟಿ. ವಿಲ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್. But consciousness is there, objects are there.
Also in consciousness. Huh? Only apart from consciousness, nothing is
there. Nothing else is there. So, first level of duality we have to remove is perceptional duality. Duality is perceptional level. Okay? So, is there a duality in the perception level? First question. Do not confuse duality with variety. Okay? At perception level, there is a variety. But variety and duality, they are two different things. Don't mix up them. Okay? So, first let us understand, is there a variety in the perception level?
Yes.
So much of variety I see.
Yes.
This color, that color, that color, that color, that color. The variety is there. Okay? Is there a duality in the perception level? Do not confuse variety and duality. Okay? So duality is I and the other. Okay, let me say that I am seeing you. I am seeing you. Is there I and you?
At perception level,
it is not there. That's also illusion.
Variety is there.
No, we'll come to the variety. I see Vaniji. Is there two I and Vaniji are there?
The worldly sense it is there,
huh?
The worldly sense it is there,
and
the spiritual sense it is
there. No. Even worldly sense and spiritual sense, there's no separation. That's only illusion. When I see Vaniji, okay. Where is Vaniji sitting? Where is she?
It doesn't matter. Because she's not there.
The problem is solved. Illusion. Somehow she has made Vasu disappear today. Every day I am giving Vasu Vani example. So disappear. Okay. So when I see something, right? Let us say I see this banana. Where is the banana?
In my consciousness.
The banana is here. My eyes are seeing. Suppose I don't have eyes. Is there a form of banana?
No.
Okay.
It's there for the touch.
Yeah.
On
so
the other senses it is still
there. Touch, eyes, ears. So one of the experiences we call as banana. Correct? Eyes are very limited in range. It can only see within certain visible range. Ears are very limited in some range. Tongue is very limited in taste. Touch is very limited. They don't have, they are very limited. The eagles have better eyes than us. The bats have better ears than us, but still they are limited. Okay. So these are like five blind men trying to figure out what is there outside. Right? Something exists, of course. But what exists depends on what sense organs you have. What sense organs you have? It depends on the instrument. Okay? Let us say you change your eyes and you have a X-ray vision. Then where is what is there here?
Nothing
is there. I give a X-ray vision to Vaniji. Then what will you see? You don't see me, you'll see a skeleton sitting here, a ghost, right? So what we see depends on our sense organ, okay? It doesn't say what is there, it only sees, tells something about our eyes, not doesn't say whatever, what sense organs are you using. You understand? Anything which you see doesn't tell anything about the object. It only tells what sense organs you are using. If your eyes are color blind, there's no color there. Okay? If your eyes are X-ray vision, you see only skeleton. If you are gamma vision, then you will not see anything in the world. So, seeing doesn't prove anything is there outside. Seeing only proves that you have some
instrument.
If you use electron microscope, what you'll see? Only electrons sitting there. Okay? So what is there, we cannot say anything. Are we clear? But we can say something. There is something. There is something, but what it is, I can't say. You understand? There is something. It's like a blind man, right? They're touching the elephant. One person touches the elephant, it is hard. Another person touches the elephant, the tail, which is soft. Trunk. So each of them are getting different feeling and none of them are true. But what they can say, there is something out there. I don't know what it is. You understand? And you can say something out there. I don't know what it is and I can never know it also. Because of my sense organs, whatever I do, the sense organs cannot tell me what is there. Sense organs, what the sense organs are doing? Sense organs are creating a picture of what is there. Some picture, what is there?
Misleading.
Useful picture. Otherwise you can't come here, no? Something useful for your operation. A picture is created from what is there, which cannot be known at all, unknowable. A blind man, five blind men can never know an elephant. It's unknowable to them. But they can make a picture out of that. Understand? So, what is out there, we can never say. We can only say about my eyes. What is out there will never be understood, can never be known, can never be thought. Are we clear? It's unknown, unknowable, and that unknown, unknowable is called Brahman. Okay? But I am making a picture out of that. Clear? Using my eyes. Can you separate that picture from my eyes? Can you separate Vaniji from my eyes?
When you turn away, then...
No, when I am experiencing, I am seeing. When I am seeing Vaniji, can you separate Vaniji from my eyes?
No.
You cannot. I change my eyes, one sense, or I see X-ray vision, then there is a skeleton there. I see gamma vision, she has disappeared. I come back to normal vision, she is there. I change my color vision, and now she becomes a black and white. Okay? And I change my vision, she lose 10 kgs, and she looks lean.
Look at our first letter.
So, right? But what you cannot do, so you cannot separate out seen from the seer. The seen and the seer, including in this case my eyes. Seen and seer are one. What you see may not be right or wrong, but seen and seer you cannot separate out. Is there duality or non-duality?
Non-duality.
Huh? What is it?
No duality.
There's no duality.
So
understand?
What happens when I close my eyes?
We'll come to that. You close your eyes and you'll see what happens. First we have to remove the duality concept in the perception itself. Okay? That...
Are they different, Guruji? This is the seer and that is the seeing.
No. In the process of seeing, can you separate out seer and see?
No. You cannot separate.
If you don't have eyes, I am not there. If you have eyes, you cannot separate me from your eyes because my image has gone into your eyes. Your image, the image in the eyes has gone to brain. Brain has to go into mind and consciousness. You cannot cut anywhere in this path and say, this is the place where the image stops. Mm-hmm. So I am seeing Vaniji, right? This light from her body is coming to me and forming a retina image in the retina. Can I say, up to this point Vaniji is there and this is the image? Eyes in the retina, it goes to the image here. So I am seeing this image. So is this point where I say, oh, this is the image and that's Vaniji?
No.
I cannot say, okay? In this whole thing is single process. The seer and seen are not two different things. Seer and seen are one. Okay? Seer and seen are connected through seeing. Seeing is the only thing which is there now. Right? Seeing, if I call as experiencing, experiencing is only there now. Experiencing is only there. Are you clear? So there is no seer and seen. There is no duality in any perception at all. Okay? This room is there. I am perceiving this room as one whole experience. I am the experiencer. Can I separate out the experience and experiencer separately? There's only experiencing is there. Okay? You cannot say, this is where room ends and this is where I begin. Come on. This is where room ends and this is where I begin. You cannot say that. Okay? So, the seer and seen are one. Just pause. Okay, then. I'll ask a question for. So this is a test now. So if people have attended so many, I pass. I'm conducting exam now. This is a semester exam. I asked a question. What is the purpose of the whole classes here? This class? Why we are coming to the classes here like this? What is the purpose? I don't know. Huh? Is there some weekend entertainment? Why? What is this? What are you sitting and doing here? What I got into is this class?
Don't know. You call me, I come.
Okay, now you can go.
You should make me go.
Okay. See, where there is duality, there is stress. Okay. Where there is duality, there is suffering. Where there is non-duality, there is no suffering, there is no stress. Okay. So the entire class of teaching of Vedanta is to understand that duality is not real at all. It's an illusion. Okay. So we have to remove the duality at various levels. First level is perception level. Is there a duality? Okay. So in seeing, is there a duality? You and me are separate. Yes or no?
No, if this process itself, there is no seeing, but we see as seer and seen, so there is a duality. If I attach myself to my body, then I think I am seeing you. But the process...
The seeing depends on the sense organs. If you see me through x-ray vision, I am only skeleton. If you see through me gamma vision, nothing is there. If you see me through colorblind eyes, I am colorless, right? Okay, so the sense organs are superimposing an image on the scene. The object is not really there. The object is created, carved out by the sense organs. Why blind men are trying to figure out what elephant is? None of them can find out what elephant is. All that they can say is, I don't know what is there. But I can say it's soft, I can say it's hard, they can say. Like that, we have five sense organs which are creating, carving out an image in a something out there. What is out there? Nobody can know. It's unknown, unknowable. Understand? That unknown, unknowable, we are carving out an image based on our sense organs. Right? Today I give you. So you become a superwoman, x-ray vision. So then what you will see me? What do you see me?
Like a skeleton.
You will see me a skeleton. Right? So sense organs are creating an image in front of us. What is there? Image is based on my sense organs. But what is out there, I never know. And what is out there, never know, is called Brahman, God. But always, it is there. We are seeing that Brahman only.
In the form that the sense organ is perceiving.
Correct. You understand? So, and will I day one day know Brahman? Not possible. But can I be Brahman? I am Brahman. You understand? There is no way I can know Brahman. Because sense organs cannot tell me. The mind cannot show me, right? It's only making a picture out of that, carving out of that. Then what is God? What out is there? God. When you do it, that's God only. Mm-hmm. When you are seeing, it's God only. And all that you have to change is understanding is, what I am seeing is God only. If this attitude you see your husband or wife, see how good your life will be. What you don't understand, when you see your husband and wife, you are seeing God only. Okay, your mind is creating some more image of that. That you find out what is that. There is nothing other than God we are seeing. Nothing other than God we are experiencing. Nothing other than God we are touching. Understand? That is unknown, unknowable reality. And how it is known? You can know, you can say there is something there. Easiness is there. So can I say this Vaniji is there? My sense organs are Vaniji is there. But I cannot definitely define what's her figure. Okay, that's my sense organs. But what I can is, there is easiness. Existence is there. The fan exists, I can say. The fan shape is my sense organs. Okay? Everything is, there is easiness, astitva. That astitva is called Brahman. When you see something, you are seeing Brahman. When you are hear something, you are Brahman. When you are experiencing something, you are Brahman. You understand? There is nothing else. But you can never know Brahman. You can never see Brahman. You can never touch Brahman. It's like blind man trying to figure out what elephant is. All that they can say is something is there. That something which is there is called Brahman. Are we clear? So, this is what is meant by Kabir Das. Kabir Das, somebody asked Kabir Das ji. Okay. Kabir Das ji, you are not going to mosque because you are mosque Muslim. You Muslims don't allow you. You can't go to Hindu temple because Hindus don't allow you. You are Muslim. Then, what are you speaking about Ram? Okay. Kabir Das ji said, whatever I see is Ram. Whatever I hear is Ram. Whatever I touch is Ram. Whatever I smell is Ram. Where do I find Ram? Now you think that something has something wrong with the Kabir Das eyes and ears. He is able to see Ram everywhere. Okay? Oh, Kabir Das sees Ram somewhere, then something is problem with his eyes. Nothing problem is only understanding. What is Ram is? Everything is Ram. Okay? And that figure call it as Katyayani, that call is Vaniji, based on your sense organs. You understand?
Form is
not there. Form is created by sense organs. That's what I said. You can put electron microscope into your eyes.
No, you are talking about the shape of the form. I am saying form exists, right? Object exists.
Object doesn't exist.
But you said easiness is there.
Easiness is not an object.
Easiness of what then?
Easiness, that's all. You cannot say what.
Think, how can easiness be there for nothing?
You can say, because you are perceiving something, you can say there is something is. What is there, nobody will know. And everything in the world is Brahman only. With your limited sense organs, you are figuring out what the hell it is there. That you call your friend, that you call your enemy, that you call husband, that you call your wife. That's neither your husband, nor your wife, nor your enemy, nor your friend. That's only Brahman. Astitva. Are you able to understand this?
Like we should imagine like energy, but form is saying that.
There's no
energy
form also.
Energy.
No, you actually, that all depends on your a little bit tightening your screws here. If I change the little bit tighter the screws, you start energy also. Okay? If you put one peg in your peg in your stomach, you see the stars and planets are swinging and dancing. Are stars, planets singing, dancing?
Guruji, I have a question.
Yeah, a question.
You are telling, we can't see Brahma, we can't experience Brahma.
No. You are experiencing Brahman only.
No, you are telling, we can't see them.
What you are seeing is Brahman only, but that you call as name and form. See, five blind men, when they touch elephant, okay, he touches the trunk and says it's soft. Somebody touches the tail and it says, somebody touches the leg and says it's hard. Are they seeing the elephant?
No.
Are they experiencing the elephant?
They are experiencing the elephant
in various forms. So whenever you are experiencing the world, you are experiencing Brahman in various forms. But none of them is true.
It's an experience
which is not fully true, it's partially true. But when you are touching and experiencing something, you are experiencing God only. All experience of you are experience of God only. Then what are you looking for? A special experience of God?
Everything is God. Why we should
use? Every experience is divine experience. Somebody said, what is that? Worldly life and spiritual life. Who said that? There is no worldly life and spiritual life. There is only divine life. Your understanding, you are correct it. When you are experiencing something, you are experiencing Brahman only. You will never be able to know what is there. Actually, you think it's husband or wife because of your sense organs in the mind. That's all. Okay? And your sense organs are so limited, like they're five blind men, they're only sensing little bit of what is there. What is reality out there? There is some reality. Okay? There is, easiness is there. The fan is, the table is, the flower is, the chair is. That easiness is called Brahman. Can you feel it, experience easiness? You cannot. You can experience it in the form of sense organs. Okay. Scientists say it's electron. And somebody says it's energy. But ultimately what is there? Existence. Easeness. Is that clear? So, is there a duality in our perception? There is no duality in perception. When I see you, I am experience of seeing. You cannot cut where is this experience of seeing begins and where is the experience of seeing ends. Oh, you are there. Are you there? Can I cut there? No. There is light from your body is coming. It is going to my eyes. Can I stop at my eyes and say that you are here? No. It is in my eyes. And it's an image in my brain, in my mind, in my consciousness. Entire thing is appearing in my consciousness. I can never separate out you from my consciousness. Now tell me, is there a duality in perception?
Perception, that itself is incomplete.
No. When you are experiencing something, there is no separation possible. Separation is duality.
In the experience, there is no duality. But when we say the word perception,
no, that's to. I mean, I have to tell something for you to understand.
Because in that experience, there is no duality. Because the seer and the seen are one. Then only the experience happens. Otherwise, there is no experience.
Correct. So, you have to give a name to that, no? So, how do I communicate? Through sense organs, whatever I am perceiving, there is no duality in perception. There is a variety in perception. Do not confuse the duality and variety. Okay, there is a different color, this is a different color, this is different height, they have a different weight, there is a variety. Okay? And
it's
again,
made out of sense organs.
Again, the variety is made out of sense organs. Okay, so when sense organs are carving out an image in that infinity. So please understand, whatever you touch, whatever you feel, whatever you experience, whatever you see, is nothing but Brahmamayam. Sarvam Brahmamayam. Then what are people looking for, an experience of God? So you will not know until you go through the teachings of rishis. Without that, people go to Himalayas, they leave their family, I want to find God, as if God is hidden in some Himalayan valleys, okay, or somewhere. It is clarity of understanding. There is no duality in perception at all. Perception is not real. Okay? But what is perceived is always real. Existence you can never deny. Can you negate existence? Nothing exists, you can say? Okay? That existence is God. It is unknowable through our sense organs. Unknowable fully. Unknowable partially. Okay? How do you know it? Very simple. Whenever I see my husband, please repeat. I am seeing God only in the form of husband.
But in the form of
God, husband doesn't.
What?
But unlike God, God is silent. Even if I think he's God, if you want to be
God, we should bring them also.
So, actually, all forms are his form. All names are his name. Meaning of that. Whatever you see, whatever you experience, is the infinite existence you are shaping through sense organs. Okay? Understand? Now, who is shaping this through sense organs? Who? Who? You means who?
Mind.
Who? That's called Shakti. So you have seen now, Narayana is resting and Lakshmi Devi is pressing the feet, Pada Sevana. And Shiva is sitting and Parvati is doing service to Shiva. Really what she is doing, okay, entire existence is Shiva. So Parvati is decorating Shiva through your sense organs in various forms. Every possible way she sees Shiva through every sense organs. Okay, through elephant eyes it looks different. Through ant's eyes it looks different. To eagle's eyes it looks different. To your eyes it looks different. So Parvati is experiencing Shiva in various ways. That is the meaning of Pada Sevana. Lakshmi is experiencing Narayana in infinite ways. How? Through your sense organs. You think you are seeing. You are also not seeing. Seeing is happening. And that seeing happening is called, the seeing power of seeing is called Lakshmi or Parvati, Shakti. And what is seen is Shiva, existence or consciousness of Narayana. So, the Narayana is being decorated by your sense organs. Anybody understand what I'm saying? Is this clear? So then Shiva and Shakti, you cannot separate out. It's one reality. Okay. Only thing is, the Shakti is seeing the Shiva or self in variety of ways through your sense organ. But what is there is existence only, which cannot be seen, which cannot be understood, which cannot be known, unknowable. Because knowing also is an intellect is required, which is a small organ. At this point of time, we can say existence is there. So whatever you are experiencing, whatever you am seeing, is Brahman. And seer and seen, I cannot separate out, that's why it's non-dual. Is this much clear to all? Anybody has a doubt?
Guruji, Nisargadatta Maharaj Chatravangrali, existence is also not there in the Alala. Again context.
Amele. Existence helbekadre buddhi beko. Aita. So buddhi ide antu godabekadre awareness beko. Avaga buddhinu illa existence merge aagibidutade. To tell something, whenever you see something, you are limiting that. Okay. So we'll come to that. First, when you are living in the world, if you are living that there is a duality, it's completely false. You understand? That's why it is said, in your life, whatever circumstance comes, you cannot resist it. Your relatives, your friends, your enemies, they come as a package deal because of your mind and sense organs. You cannot separate it out. You think that, oh, this is I don't like. That like and I and that like have come together as a single package. The husband you have got as a package deal from the heaven. You cannot. It's a single package. You and husband are made for each other. That's why I said marriages are made in heaven. It's not made here. You cannot escape that. Because that it's a single perception. You cannot cut it. Everything which is happening in your life is one single perception which is coming from you. So, there's no point in resisting or fighting with the present moment, except that this is my perception which is manifesting as this reality. There's no reality, there's only perception which is coming from me. There's nothing, something out there.
Understand? Perception or creation? It's my creation.
Perception or creation, is
perception
there a difference?
Is only what is already there.
There's nothing already there. There's only existence there. Oh, mom is laughing. There's nothing out there. It's existence only. So in that existence, you are calling out when nice fellow called Prasad. Why you called out? I don't know. But you have called out. Now you can't come to carry out. No, I don't want Prasad. Okay, I want something else. It doesn't work that way. Once you have called out your sense organs mind, it is there. That's why marriages are made in heaven. It's not made here. Okay, it may be lived in hell. That's a different thing. It's always a single unitary perception. Okay? Another example I can give you. In your dream, you went to Paris. Was there a Paris earlier? Was there a dream body? The dream body and Paris and experience of Paris is a single experience. You may think that I went to Paris by plane. Plane also came there. Your totality of perception is one single experience. Where you cannot separate out who is the experience and who is the experiencer. No way you can do it. Are we clear? So where is the duality, my dear?
No
duality. There's no duality in any perception. Seer and seen is connected through seeing. Okay? Is seeing there? Seeing is knowing. I know that this is seeing. There's a knowing is there. So my nature is knowing. That itself I'm experiencing moment to moment. There's nobody other than myself. In perception also. You're able to understand? See, we get stressed out that something happening in life. There's nothing happening in life. It's my own perceptions are getting projected. In your dream, the dream tiger came. There was never a tiger. It's your mind which gets projected. Your mind. A mountain came. There's no mountain. It's your mind projected the mountain. You have projected your husband. You have projected wife. You have projected your enemies. You have projected your friends. And say they are different. How is possible? How we can separate out? Is this much clear to all? So this is the real meaning of Parvati is doing service to Shiva. Lakshmi is doing service to Narayana. What she is doing, only service is she is decorating in various ways and seeing in various ways. Perceptions. All perceptions are Parvati. All perceptions are Lakshmi. And you cannot separate out perceiver and perceived. Only thing is, Lakshmi is very fashion conscious. Okay? She wants to see every moment changing. Doesn't want anything, one last moment, what is there? Next. In your Paris and London, there's a fashion season. Once in 6 months or once in 8 months, there's a fashion week. This Lakshmi and Parvati, they are very fashion conscious. They don't want to see the husband in same way next minute. Every minute they want to see the husband in different way. I'm sure you also like that, but it doesn't happen. Every minute perception changes. Because every minute, every object we are seeing is changing. Your body is changing, your mind is changing, your intellect is changing, the world is changing. The one who is perceiving, the body, mind, intellect is also changing. Every minute new perception rises.
But it's very consistent. Otherwise...
Whether consistency will come to that. First will come to that.
Prabhuji will look the same every time I imagine or perceive, right?
I'll come to that. Why I look same?
Right. Even any object for that matter, Guruji. So each of us, if we think like, I mean, that there is no duality, so is that the reason why an object looks the same for all of us?
We'll find out. See, our sense organs are not sharp enough to see, notice the changes. Okay? So tomorrow I'll repair your eyes a little bit and I show you. Look at the world in the energy way, then you see he does that person is just changing energy pattern. It's only a limitation of sense organs making us. Others say it's just the energy flow. The energy flow we are seeing because the limitation is our sense organs, not the. Our sense organs' ability is I am not able to detect small changes. Right?
Limited.
I am sure you have the ability also. Many things you don't notice the change, but little bit changes in your husband's face, you know, notice those. He also doesn't know, but you can see them changes. Our eyes are sharp enough to notice some small changes.
Depends on what we say.
So, these Lakshmi and Parvati, they are very fashion conscious. They don't want to see one thing next moment. Every moment everything is changing, continuously changing. Continuously perceptions are rising and falling.
That is why they send their husbands to earth to take another avatar or whatever.
So are we clear? There's no duality in perception. Anybody contest this? Anybody has a wrong... But there's a variety in perception because of sense organs. Okay? Never confuse variety with the duality.
Yeah.
Is this much clear to all? Suresh is very silent today. Agreed or not agreed?
Yeah.
So duality is a illusion in perception. So if the example which I give you is in your dream you went to Paris. You ate pizza and you went on Eiffel Tower. Is pizza different from you? Is Eiffel Tower different from you? Is Paris different from you? Is same you. Similarly, your husband is you. Your children is you, your enemy is you, your friend is you. Why are you living illusion that they are different?
Wrong perceptions.
Huh? Perception is right, and interpretation is wrong.
Understanding
is wrong. So, if there is a suffering in my life because of this relationship, that's what is your creation at this moment. And that's what you exactly need at this moment. That's why the creation has happened. Nothing happens for your... everything happens for your evolution. Because you are the creator of that. So that perception of yours, what's happening at this moment. I am suffering because of this relationship. This happening. That's exactly what you need at this moment. That's why it's happening, because there's no duality at all. In your dream, you went to Paris and ate pizza. Just like that Paris appeared, is it? There was a desire in you to have the Paris. There is a desire in you to go to Paris. There is a desire in you to go to Eiffel Tower. And that desire manifested. Similarly, every relationship in your life is there, appearing from your consciousness exactly appropriate to that moment, okay, to fulfill certain deep-rooted necessity or desire in you.
Pain is also a desire?
Of course. Of course. I'll tell you how pain is a desire, right? You are sleeping. You have kept an alarm clock. I want to get up at 5 o'clock. 5 o'clock alarm rings. Shut. So you're not, you're ignoring alarm clock. Then I'll tell you, there is a special alarm clock available. Okay? You come and complain to me, alarm clock is not working. Every day I have sleep and I keep the alarm and I shut down the alarm and sleep again. And I'll tell you, there is a special alarm clock. Okay? So that's connected to your bed. At 5:30 exactly, it'll give a shock to you. Now you don't have a way of not getting up. So many times pain is required for us to wake up. That's a deep rooted desire for me to wake up. Pain is also that. All suffering in your life is an alarm clock kept by you to wake up from the dream called life. It's your own alarm. Normal alarms didn't work for you, so you went for a special alarm clock. Otherwise, why do you think so many people are coming to this class, my dear? I was wondering why people are coming to this class. Such a wonderful Sunday morning, not going to enjoy a cricket match. I think you have very severe alarms in your house.
Special alarms.
Special alarms.
But Guruji, everybody who is in pain, severe pain, they are not on the path of spirituality, or they are not seeking Guru. Their life is going with pain and suffering.
No, they are. They go to the temple. The alarms are there, but still they are not waking up. That's, alarm is not good enough for them to.
Good enough.
Sooner or later, they have to realize that this alarm is not for me.
Yeah.
They have to go for a stronger alarm.
Stronger alarm, right? It's every time, it's what happens in life. Every time you drink a cup of coffee, next time you want a stronger dose of coffee. Okay, little bit more stronger, little bit more stronger. Like that, we also get immune to these alarms. Okay, please understand, every single experience in your life, good or bad, is coming from your inner consciousness at that moment for your
betterment.
So that's why Sri Krishna said in Bhagavad Gita, whatever is happening is for your good. That's the meaning of that. Is that clear? There is no duality. There is only experience. There is no experience and experience. They are coming together. It's a single package. Okay? But there are experiences, rise and fall, experiences rise and fall in consciousness. Is this much clear to all? Any doubts? So at perception level, there is no duality. Then where is the duality coming into picture? Each perception leaves an impression, memory, vasana. Okay, each perception leaves an impression. Okay, now this perception is momentary, it ends. But using all these impressions, you create a continuity of impressions. Understand? Only memory is giving you continuity. So my dear, I erase your memory, then what are you?
Nothing.
Nothing?
Fresh in the moment.
If I am erase your memory.
Yeah, I am nothing.
I'm clean system.
Just like
this. If I erase your memory, where is the suffering? Every moment is a new experience. It appears and disappears for a child, like a child.
Live in the moment.
Live in the moment. So, your cause of suffering is not the experience, but memory which is continuing, memory which is recorded at each event, and you are putting them together and creating a hell out of that.
Because that's why that karma, in one of the sessions you had explained, it continues.
Experiences rising and falling in consciousness, just like waves are rising and falling in ocean. Okay? But compared to your ocean, what you have is something called memory, where you keep recording each experience. And out of this experience, you create a self-identity. And this self-identity creates a duality. So, if I am seeing you now, as if I am seeing first time, I look at you with the child's eye, there's no duality. But I am not a child, my memory comes into picture. Oh, this is Vaniji, I give a name. This is me, Prabhu. The duality is not in perception, duality is in the naming of the perception.
Memory
is naming. You understand? Every experience in life is non-dual. But an apparent duality comes because of the naming which happens subsequently. Are you clear?
So when I came to the first class, I was like a child. Now I have got all the memories that this is Guruji, he is sitting, he tells the this thing, that thing.
Right.
So I have acquired...
So, there's no problem. This is all part of life. See, there are so many bags and baggage we acquire. You have to learn how to live with that baggage without affected by them. That's all is learning. You cannot reverse yourself and have it. There's no gun which will erase your memory. Okay, there's nothing which will take you to childhood. So, once you start understanding what baggage we are carrying and the illusory nature of the baggage, will not be affected by that. It's only through jnana we should get over. There's no other way. Okay. So, the duality is not in perception. Duality is in naming of the perception. Naming comes from memory. For a child, there's no naming. It just experiences life as it comes. And that is a bliss. And that experience is called pure experience. Right now also, every experience you are having is a pure experience. But the every experience of pure experience, you are immediately putting it with the experience based on the memory. Are you getting it? So, and you are creating a identity and a sequence.
Tagging it.
Understand? But experience is non-dual. Purnima? Are you clear? So that is the meaning of Purnima, Purnatva. Every experience is Purna, complete.
In itself.
Every experience is infinite. Purnamadha, Purnamidam, Purna, Purnamudachyate, Purnasya, Purnamadaya, Purnameva Avashishyate. That is Purna, consciousness Purna. Purnamidam means this experience is Purna. But that Purna becomes Apurna because of the memory. Understand? Are you clear? So every experience of our life is divine experience. Do you know that? No, divine means some light has to come, something has to come, nothing has to come. Every experience is Purna, Purna Madam, Purna Midam.
But can we use the word part of existence? It is always existence is Purna.
Existence you cannot make it part, no. The part is only notional.
Using word part of existence is not correct.
There cannot be parts in existence. Say, for example, this chair is there, that chair is there. In between there is a gap. Has existence broken? Chair exists, that chair exists, in between space exists. Existence cannot be broken. Astitva is complete, totality. Purnamadaha, consciousness is fullness. Purnamidaha, this experience is fullness. Purnat, Purnamuduchyate. Purnat, Purnamuduchyate. Remove the name and form, then what remains is also Purna. So naming, form just gives a variety. Naming gives, separates out the variety.
Distinguishes it.
Have you done all this, this finger exercise, everybody?
Yeah.
Huh? Everybody has done this finger exercise?
Yes.
Where is your left finger beginning and ending? You have done that?
Yes.
Last class you are not there? Not done. Okay. For those who are not done, repeat. Take your left hand, right finger, left finger. Take your right hand, this finger, and show where the right, left finger begins and left finger ends. Show me. End. Okay, left finger begins here and ends here. Now do the finger like this. Okay, to move this finger, blood has to come. Where the blood is coming from? So where is the beginning of the finger? Here. And ending here. Right? No, no, not over. Yeah, till you understand, you have to keep doing like this.
Now I remember.
Okay. So, you have done this exercise?
Yes.
Sir. Okay. So, where is the finger beginning? Show me. Ending here. Okay. So, now to brain to operate, you need oxygen. Where is oxygen coming from? So it's here. So where is the air for the lungs coming from? So finger is here, all here. So that's why we keep fingering people. Finger is all around. Okay. So can there be air without the earth?
No.
So where is the finger?
It's beginning from
here. Can earth be there without sun? Can sun be without a galaxy? No. So where is the beginning of your finger?
Everywhere.
Everything in the universe is connected to everything else in the universe. But what our mind does, if that is the understanding, we cannot operate. So mind cuts it. Mind says only this much is the finger. Okay? The mind for functional purpose. So you have to somewhere you have to. But reality is we are connected to the entire universe. I am the universe. Right? So that understanding frees you. Otherwise you live with what mind says. Mind says is okay. It's for functional purpose. Don't confuse the functional purpose with reality. Right? For a functional purpose, husband is a dog. Naming purpose is a husband. Don't confuse the realities. The moment you start confusing the reality, you start putting so much of maya on that. What is functional? What is reality? You understand? Right? So mind is there for functional purpose. So it says cuts the finger into it. But that is not reality. Right? What is reality? I'll tell repeat. Sahasra Shirsha Purushaha Sahasraksha Sahasrapat Sabhumim Vishuto Vratva Atyatishta Dashangulam. Purusha means your consciousness. Sahasra Shirsha means thousand heads. It's not thousand heads. Millions of heads. Infinite number of heads. Sahasra Shisha Purja Sahasraksha, millions of heads. Every head is the head of consciousness, Brahman. So the one consciousness is seeing through your eyes, your eyes, your eyes, your eyes, your eyes. Only one consciousness. Okay? Only one consciousness seeing through all the eyes. One consciousness is walking through all the legs. One consciousness is eating through all the mouths. That is consciousness, and you are that consciousness. And because of the mind, you start thinking, I am this limited. Actually, there's infinity. There's no boundless, you are the boundless consciousness. Mind tells something, and that is required for functional purpose, operational purpose. Don't confuse the functional purpose with the reality. Is this clear at all? No duality in the perception is clear? Any questions about this much? So the duality comes because of the memory experiences.
Guruji, memories are selective, right? So who is in control of that memory being?
We'll find out, right? So, this much is clear to all?
Sir, you said duality is because of memory, you told, no? As you told that memory is like...
Naming.
Naming.
Variety is because of sense organs.
Naming means that is also thought only.